Okay, so we are having our third game of the round three finished. Boris Gelfand just won his game against Vincent Kaimer. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Maybe you would like to share some ideas about the game. For example, it was pretty interesting when you played this knight-d4 move. I believe it's quite a novelty, so to say.
No, but basically knight-c3, it's almost a novelty. It's a new idea. Okay, it's playable. Yeah, it's playable. Knight-d4 is a point, and I think... So here I have b3 is a good move, and I have full compensation. If he takes, I take, and it's typical Catalan compensation. And he tried to... here it's interesting, but he has to take, rook d1, I have to play. I don't know if he has to play queen b6 or not, probably yes. And now it's tricky because, okay, my pawn a4 is a good move, knight e4, and the point if I cannot play a3 because of f5 because of d3. Oh, sorry, no, and okay, f2 is hanging. So queen d3, and also here I calculated very interesting combination to take and go here. Queen has to go. We go here. Queen goes here, and the queen c7 with IP. But unfortunately, I think it doesn't work because he plays bishop c5. Oh, sorry, bishop, override. I take, and he takes with a knight, and okay, a lot of checks here. Maybe I missed something completely, but queen d3 is a good move, it consolidates position. And the point, if he will play knight c5 now, then a5 is strong. Knight d3. And maybe, I don't know, probably here is position sort of the problematic, maybe rook d8 he has to play. But he played bishop f6, and I played a5, queen c5, knight h4, and it's a big advantage. I don't think I spoiled somewhere. Yeah,
yeah, well, it's a big pressure on the diagonal.
It's a big pressure on diagonal, knight d6 probably must, rook c1, bishop b4.
Yes, you have to give up the exchange.
Yes,
here.
Yes. Rook d8. I thought, okay, bishop c7, I better take. I thought bishop h3 maybe to play for some compensation, but it's not real compensation. Yeah, I take, take, and probably I'm in time.
Or maybe on d5?
He played on d5.
Oh, he
played. And now I think I take, take, and probably even d6 immediately. I hoped so, yeah? Because you run very quick.
Yeah. He has two bishops, but it's not easy.
Yeah, not easy. Yeah, the pawn is strong. And bishop d5, I took knight g2, I kind of consolidated. And I think, I think I didn't miss anything.
Yeah. There were also pretty nice moves afterwards when you played, for example. Yeah. Here.
Yeah, rook c7.
Rook c7, very nice. Yeah. Trapping basically with the queen, he has to trade.
Yes.
And even when he attacks your
Yes. Maybe it was not necessary. Maybe I could go back.
But just very beautiful.
But beautiful, yeah.
So knight d3, and again, knight c5 also, yeah.
Yeah, bishop d5, knight a6. Yeah, he could play rook a8, but I don't think it will help much.
But it's still lost position for black.
Yeah.
Pawn is just too strong, and...
Yeah. Here, whatever wins you. Change up for no compensation.
So congratulations.
Thank you, pretty good game.
Yeah, so you have been last time, I guess, in Bill in 2009, is it correct?
Yes, I think
so. It's the first time so many years?
Yes, but I had been, maybe I'm still been more than all other players taken together, yeah?
Yeah, of course. How do you feel yourself here in Bill now, especially at these hard times?
No, it's very nice, nice, okay, a lot of memories, you know, you go to certain places and you remember you've been here 93 or, I don't know, 97 or something, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
But it's nice to be back here, nice to be back, nice to play chess.
It's a big honor and pleasure to have you here at Grandmaster Triathlon.
Thank you. yeah. So far, okay, first round I made a horrible mistake,
but I hope, okay. We hope it will get better,
yes.
So today already on the winning,
yes.
hopefully
yes.
on the winning streak.
I hope.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you, and see you.
See you.